The ceramic coating is just fantastic. I mean, it is unbelievable how mirror-esque this black paint is. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel, welcome back to the vlog, and welcome back to another video in the series of perfecting the ZR2. Today we have a couple different things planned for the ZR2, so let's jump right into it. All right, guys, so I'm sure by now you have seen my previous videos. We have done a lot of different things with the Colorado ZR2. We've done tail lights, we've done LEDs, we've done ditch lights, we've done Expel, we've done some blacking out of different parts of the truck. And today we get to do one of the final things. I say one of the final things because this truck is never actually finished, but the big thing today is going to be taking the truck to blackout tinting to get it ceramic coated. So yes, you can ceramic coat on top of the Expel paint protection, and what that's gonna do is just give this truck an unbelievable shine and even more protection against bird droppings and environmental fallout and stuff like that. Plus, it's gonna make it a lot easier to clean, and it's going to just make that black paint shine. It's gonna look like a mirror when it's all said and done. For those of you who are not familiar with the channel, this is my C7 Corvette ZR1. It is Expelled, and it is also ceramic coated on top of that Expel. And that is why that thing looks so gloriously shiny all the time. And it's a real treat to wash. It's very easy to keep clean because the dirt basically just wants to fall off of it. That's what we're gonna be doing with the ZR2 today as well. But before we do, we're gonna do a little mod to the front end of the truck that's gonna make a gigantic difference before we leave for blackout tinting. So let's jump into that one first, because this is one that I have not seen anybody else do with the ZR2 just yet. So here we are at the front of the truck, and if you guys are like me, there's one thing that just really stands out on this otherwise blacked out truck, and it's the bow tie. So naturally the bow tie is chrome because that's what Chevy does with their bow ties, the chrome on the outside and then typically the gold on the inside. But with the 2021 models, that is actually a flow tie, so there is no gold to be had there, which is, you know, one pro, I guess. But at the same time, I don't like the chrome outline there when the rest of the truck is pretty much black other than the headlights, which hopefully those will be worked on here soon too. Now, my big concern was, is this thing one piece with the grill? How does it come off? Is it made to come off? And luckily for me, one of the subscribers actually reached out to me via email and said, hey, why don't you paint that thing? And I said, well, I've been trying to figure out a way to get it off there to paint it. I didn't really want to have to mask everything off to paint, but he told me that does come off, and he actually showed me how it comes off. So we're going to take that off today. And the real huge benefit of all of this is that he actually sent me a black one so I can see where the clips are at. So yeah, we're going to get this done in a way that is almost professional because of you guys. This is why this kind of stuff is so beneficial. We work back and forth and we get these kind of things done. I mean, just look at how much better that's going to look. Now, basically, this particular subscriber told me what he did was take a real flexible putty knife and go around it, because ultimately what we have to do is push in those clips right there as you're pulling out. And there's actually, there's a surprising number of these clips for this tiny little thing. At the end of the day, this thing's maybe 5 or 6 inches long, and there is 6 clips holding this thing to the grill. I don't think it necessarily had to have that many clips. I think like 2 or 3 would have done just fine, but apparently Chevy really did not want this thing ever coming off. So we're gonna work around the stock chrome one, get it off there, and then we're gonna pop in the new satin black version that my subscriber actually sent me. Huge thank you to you, by the way. This piece from GM is only like $6 or $7. I'll link it in the description below if you guys are interested, but I'm gonna go ahead and get the rest of these off, and then I'll be back with you on exactly how to do it. All right, so we got it off. Now, the only problem is that I did end up breaking it. I got that much of it off before it broke. Now, like I said, this is not an overly expensive piece, so what I would recommend doing is actually buying another one before you attempt to remove this. I'll put a link to this particular part number down below so you guys can grab one before you jump into this. So we're ready to go to just pop this piece back on there, but I wanted to kind of give you guys an idea of how I removed this thing. So the Cliff Notes are basically this. The silver bezel is here. You take your trim tool and you push it into this corner here and twist it up. And as you're twisting it up, it's going to pop out this clip here and start to pop out this one. Then after that, take this same trim tool and put it in between right here and slide it up, and it will pop out the top one. Then after that, you can take this trim tool and slide it towards this way and above the clip, and it will pop out that one. Do the same thing down here to pop out the bottom one. You'll stick it in between and just slide it along here, and it will eventually pop this one out. And then you'll do the same with these two over here. You'll slide it along here, pop that one out, slide it along here, pop that one out, and then you are good to go. Anyway, I'm gonna pop in the other one, and then we are gonna head up to blackout tinning. All these hours of work for this right here. So just line up the clips and push, and you should be all set. There it is. So the finished product, definitely worth it. It looks really, really good. Like I said, it's gonna kind of match the matte of the plastic here and all around the opening. So it's still gonna be visible on top of the gloss black grill, but not punch you in the face as bad as the chrome did. Anyway, let's jump in the truck. We're going to blackout tinning for the next step.
5 minutes later.
All right, guys, so here we are at blackout tinning. We've been here a couple times before. They recently did the Expel all over the truck. The entire thing is completely covered with Expel, which is their paint protection, which of course will stop scratches and rock chips and that sort of thing from hitting the actual paint. Now, on top of that, what we're doing today is we're dropping it off again for some Expel Fusion, which is Expel's version of ceramic coating. So the ceramic coating will go right on top of the Expel PPF or paint protection film, and of course enhance the gloss of the shiny black paint, as well as protect on a different layer. So protection against bugs, bird droppings, stuff like that, and it will make it a lot easier to clean. So water will basically just bead right off of it. And during my normal car washes, the soap will be a lot more effective at removing bugs and all that stuff, because nothing's gonna wanna stick to the surface. So if you want absolute protection, paint protection film and ceramic coating at the same time is the way to go. But we are dropping it off here at Blackout because they have done it for me multiple times in the past. They have proven themselves to be the best shop I have ever been to. And of course, I trust them with all my vehicles, my truck included. So we're going to drop it off here and they're going to have it for a few days until they are 100% done. And then we will be back to pick this thing up.
3 days later.
All right, guys, so we just got back from blackout tinning. Never mind the music, my neighbors are having some sort of crazy party, but I had to show you the shine on this thing, the absolute fantastic, glorious reflection. I mean, you can clearly see, it's like a mirror. So as usual, guys, blackout tinning knocks it out of the park. The ceramic coating is just fantastic. I mean, it is unbelievable how mirror-esque this black paint is. If you set a camera close enough to the side of it, you probably wouldn't be able to tell the difference between the reflection and the actual thing happening over here. So just for giggles, let's take a look. So yeah, like right down the line there, it is almost impossible to tell between my crappy shed and the reflection of it which one's real. So yeah, guys, I'm telling you, the ceramic coating is the way to go if you want to protect your vehicles. This is it. As usual, blackout tinning takes care of business. They ceramic coated the wheels, they put some tire shine on, and yeah, I mean, just look at this. It's like a mirror. It's incredible. I love the black paint whenever it is done right, and when you Expel it and ceramic coat it, it is done right. Anyway, guys, we have at least one other thing planned here that's gonna help take care of some of the tie down issues in the bed. So let's jump into the next bit of this video, which is gonna be adding some tie down points to your Colorado, and you can do it on the cheap. This is some of the cheapest stuff I've found, and it is really, really, really high quality stuff. So yeah, let's jump in and take a look at what we're gonna do with the tie down points on the Colorado ZR2. And since I know I've made a couple videos recently showing the old stock taillights, I just wanted to show you guys these are still in place. Those other videos were filmed a couple months ago and I wasn't able to put them out until just recently, but yeah, these are still here. They're not going anywhere. I freaking love these things. And with the fix that I put in place, they're never gonna need replaced. So yeah, these are definitely getting a big thumbs up from me. But anyway, the last mod for today's video is in this box and it involves this bed. Now, I know it's kind of dirty. You guys are gonna find out why it's dirty here probably in the next video. But spoiler alert, I did find some off-roading. Me and my friend took both of our ZR2s out there and we had a freaking blast. Stay tuned for that video, it's coming very soon. But just so you know, here's the box. Here's the mods. This is it. So these are really, really freaking cool, guys. So these are basically tie downs. ZR2, Z71, pretty much any of the Colorados have these tie down points. Now, what's really cool about these is this box actually contains 13 of them. So 13 of these little tie down anchor points, and that will take care of all 13 blank spots in the bed. But what's even cooler is they're black. So they're gonna match the ZR2, they're gonna match the spray and bed liner, they're gonna match everything. But what's even cooler than that is these things are only like 30 bucks on Amazon. So of course, I will link them in the description down below so you guys can get them for your Colorados. But we're gonna go ahead and get these installed. I'm gonna show you kind of the process. There really isn't a whole lot to it. It is very simple, and this is gonna be very useful. If you guys put anything in your bed, literally anything, these are super useful. Now, the bed obviously comes with 4 tie down points from factory, but this is gonna add another 13. So you can pretty much arrange stuff however you want back here at this point. So let's go ahead and get one of these installed and add some more functionality to the already very functional ZR2. So first things first, guys, you wanna take these things out of the box, and inside each one comes in a separately sealed bag, just like this. So all 13 are individually packaged, and they come with a little rubber felt pad like this. Now what we wanna do is actually pull out the center so we can expose the outer edge of it, which is actually what we're gonna use on the tie down point. So if you can see there, it's kind of separating from the center part. This is the part we're gonna use. This is actually gonna stick right on here. So when we tighten it down to the bed itself, there is something in between two pieces of metal. Nothing rubs, makes any harsh noises, or worst case scenario, scratches off paint. Once we're happy with the placement, just kind of rub your fingers over it to lock it all down so it is ready to now be installed on the truck. That's it. Now let's go ahead and get this thing in there. So here we are on the passenger side of the bed, and as you can see right there, that is a blank to fill in what is otherwise a tie down point in the bed. So we need to remove this. They aren't on there with any kind of serious strength or anything. You can pretty much just grab with a screwdriver of some kind and pop them out. Or in my case, we'll just use a trim pry tool so nothing gets scratched up. What you're gonna wanna do is just get this behind the rubber fill plate here and then just pop it out. Just like that. So it is kind of plastic. There is a little bit of a ridge behind it that's gonna kind of hold it in place. But as you can see now, that is a hole. It literally goes all the way through the bed and down under. Now what we wanna do is take the tie down point and make sure it is set up like that when you stick it through the hole. Once it's through the hole, you'll turn the nut on the other side. So this part kind of drops down like that, and then you'll start tightening it up. Ultimately, that's gonna hold it in place just like that. So with the bottom flat like this, we'll stick it in, turn the bolt head, and it is locked into place now. Now we'll start tightening it down. It is probably easiest done with a ratcheting box wrench like this, because there's not a whole lot of room between the actual tie down point and the bolt that you need to tighten down. And that's it. So that's all there is to it. Once you tighten it up, it is ready to go. Now, I'm obviously going to do that 12 more times to make sure that I have all these tie down points done. There is literally 13 blanks on the back of this truck. One purchase will get you all 13. Like I said, this is something like $30, maybe $33 from Amazon. I'll link it in the description down below. It's super useful for anybody who's using this even remotely as a truck. Anything you need to tie down, obviously these 4 stock tie down points are usually not enough, but now you'll have more. You'll have 13 more. And just like that, guys, we are done. All 13 of them all have tie down hooks. Instead of the blank little pieces of plastic, we put in this hook, which is, like I said, all black. We'll match the ZR2, match the bed liner, and it's all good to go. Like I said, these were actually really cheap, really simple to install, and they'll be super useful for any kind of off-roading or any kind of cargo carrying. Anyway, guys, that is going to do it for today's video. So if you liked what you saw, please give me a big thumbs up. Like I said, all the stuff we've done today will be linked in the description down below. If you're interested in grabbing any of this stuff for your Colorado, definitely check it out. If you guys haven't subscribed yet, please do. I'm gonna have loads of Colorado content like this coming. You're not gonna want to miss. And as always, guys, I will catch you in the next upload.